हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ओड टू ऑटम, अ ब्यूटीफुल पोएम बाय जॉन कीट्स। जॉन कीट्स, द रोमांटिक पोएट ऑफ लैटर जनरेशन, रोट सिक्स ओड्स एंड द ग्रेटेस्ट ऑफ दिस सिक्स इज कॉल्ड ओड टू ऑटम। जॉन कीट्स रोट दिस पोएम इन 1890. It was published the next year, that is 1820. It was included in his collection of poems entitled Lamia, Isabella, The Eve of Saint Agnes, and other poems. The poem describes the three different aspects of the autumn. The poem is short one. It consists of just three stanza, each stanza containing 11 lines. However, it is remarkable for the use of imagery. Its rich imagery fascinates us. Do read once the original text, you will enjoy it. Let us concentrate on multiple choice questions on ode to autumn. MCQs on ode to autumn. Number one, which of the following is true to ode to the autumn? Options are A, it is one of the famous odes by John Keats. B, it was first published in 1820. C, it is included in his collection of poems entitled Lamia, Isabella, The Eve of Saint Agnes, and other poems. D, all these are true. Correct option is D, all these are true. Number two, John Keats' poem entitled Ode to Autumn consists of dashka stanzas. Options are A, 3, B, 5, C, 7, D, 11. Correct option is A, 3. Number 3. With which of the following epithet does Keats hail autumn? Options are A, the season of mists, B, the season of mellow fruitfulness, C, both, D, none. Correct option is C, both. Number 4. Identify from the following the bosom friend of the autumn. Options are A, the vine, B, the maturing sun, C, cottage, D, bees. Correct option is B, the maturing sun. Number 5. As John Keats cites, autumn is conspiring with dashes. Options are A, wine, B, cottage, C, bees, D, the sun. Correct option is D, the sun. Number 6. As John Keats thinks in his ode to autumn, the autumn is conspiring with the maturing sun about dashes. Options are A, how to load the wines with fruits, B, how to paint the apple with fruits, C, how to fill fruits with ripeness to the core, D, all these. Correct option is D, all these. Number 7. The autumn and the maturing sun plan to grow the size of dashes. Options are A, gourd, B, the sets of hazelnuts, C, both, D, none of these. Correct option is C, both. Number 8. As John Keats thinks, the flowers that come later are for dashes. Options are A, bees, B, weavers, C, redbreast, D, maturing sun. Correct option is A, bees. Number 9. Where can one find the personified autumn sitting carelessly? Options are A, on the floor in her gallery, B, on the bank of the brook, C, in the half curly furrow, D by the shaded press. Correct option is A, on the floor in her gathering. Then the winnowing wind slowly licks atoms dash dash. Options are A, the handkerchief, B, skirt, C, hair, D, hand. Correct option is C, hair. Number 11. Where can one find the person of high autumn enjoying a sound sleep? Options are A, on the floor of her store, B, on the bank of the brook, C, in the half-reaped furrow, D, at none of these places. Correct option is C, in the half-reaped furrow. Number 12. Who of the following is presented in the ode to autumn crossing the brook with the load on her head? Options are A, personified autumn, B, self-hardress, C, gleaner, D, none of these. Correct option is A, personified autumn. Number 13. At which of the following place can one find autumn seated watching for hours? Options are A, by the side of the shaded press, B, in the half-leaf furrow, C, in her stall, D, on the bank of the brook. Correct option is A, by the side of the shaded press. Number 14. The personified autumn finds seated by the shaded press watching dash dash for hours. Options are A, shaded press, B, the customers, C, the beauty of the surrounding, D, apple juice trickle down drop by drop. Correct option is D, apple juice trickle down drop by drop. Number 15. In the Ode to Autumn, the poet asks, where are the songs of dash dash? Options are A, the spring, B, the summer, C, the autumn, D, the winter. Correct option is A, the spring. Number 16. Whom does the poet suggest not to think of the song of spring? Options are A, the sun, B, vines, C, flowers, D, autumn. Correct option is D, autumn. Number 17. Why does the poet suggest not to think of the song of spring to autumn? Options are A, for it is superior to her song, B, for it is of much lesser quality as compared to her old song, C, autumn has her own song, D, the reason is not explicit. Correct option is C, the autumn has her own song. Number 18. Which of the following image of the autumn cannot be found in the Ode to Autumn? Options are A, seated carelessly on the floor in her store, B, enjoying some sleep in the half-leaf furrow, C, fishing on the bank of the brook, D, seated by the side of shaded press. Correct option is C, fishing on the bank of the brook. Number 19. Which of the following sound constitutes the song of autumn? Options are A, willful moan of small gnats, B, bleating of the lamb, C, song of the hedge cricket, D, all these. Correct option is D, all these. Number 20. The redbreast's whistle is heard from dash dash in Keats' poem entitled Ode to Autumn. Options are A, a garden plot, B, hills, C, garnery, D, elsewhere. correct option is A, the garden crop. Number 21, which of the following is true to or to cotton? Options are A, John Keats wrote it in 1819. B, it depicts three different aspects of cotton. C, it is very remarkable for the use of imagery. D, all these are true. Correct option is D,